What's going on, guys? Matt over here with Lethal Garage, and today I have an updated 0 to 60 number for my car. Now, a few things have happened, and I'm just going to be up front with you guys before you watch any more of this video. There's not a lot of footage here because this was a quick run. So I did a little bit of tire warm-up. You can see it here. And then we actually got chased out of the area. Some guy peeked over his fence. I called the cops on you guys.
What's that?
Like, you know what? I don't want to deal with the cops today. So Kyle hopped in the car. We found a different place. And we did this run, and it surprised me. Now, here's the run, and I'll talk about it after you guys see it. So, 3.0 seconds, as you can see in the footage, it surprised me. And, I was like, was that just pure tire spin? Was that what? And you can clearly see the speedometer. The tire was spinning from 0 to about 33, 34 miles an hour, and then it hooked, and basically I hit 60 so quick, I was just like, what? There's no way. But it was, you know, and so the only other way to do this and officially do it, because again, this is just the car tracking. And again, the wheel size diameter wise is basically the same as the stock wheel. It is the 17 running a 45 tall tire. And so the speedometer is not really off. We went down, I had it checked, and it's like within 0.01% difference. So it's like nothing, you know, and that being stated, I was shocked. A 3.0 0 to 60 with my car on local city streets that's gravelly and terrible. I'm pretty confident the car can get to lower, but until I actually go to an eighth mile, quarter mile track where I can get, you know, 60 foot and 0 to 60 times and stuff like that on a prep surface, I won't know for sure. But as of right now, that run, the car was telling me I did 0 to 60 in 3.0 seconds. I don't think that's terrible. I think that's actually pretty good for the power. I think it can be better if it was better prepped and everything. Considering the power I'm putting to the wheels right now, it seems very feasible and very likely that that's the number. And it, I mean, I'm assuming I should be able to get a 2.8 if I can get good traction. Maybe. I don't know. We'll see. But yeah, 0 to 60. Check it out one more time. And I'll throw in a burnout just ahead of it for the heck of it. And it wasn't even really a good burnout. Whatever, here it goes. But yeah, that's it. Let me know, what have you guys done for 0 to 60s? What have you guys done at the track times with your builds? I'd love to know what your builds are, where they're at, what kind of power you're getting. I'm hoping in a quarter mile, I should be in the mid-10s. I think I should be. I think I would be disappointed if I wasn't. I don't think I'll be any faster than that. Driver mod issues aside, maybe slower than that. We'll see. But it's coming. It's finally happening. There's the helmet. It's all wrapped up. I got the welds. They're still on the car right now. So hopefully we can find a track day. I'm gonna be finding some side streets so I can work on my launch. But outside of that, I'm ready. I'm ready for numbers. I'm ready for some epic videos to post in the channel, finally, of some runs. So stay tuned for that. If you guys enjoy this content, hit that subscribe button. If not, likes, comments, shares are appreciated. But as always, check out Lethal Garage swag down below. New hats, shirts, all that stuff available at lethalgarage.com. And if you guys need oil, Lethal Synthetics, hit me up. I can get you the best deal on AMS oil possible. So hit me in those DMs, messages, or Instagram, wherever. So, or even email me. So either or, thanks again. And until next time, I'll see you on the road.